this country, you gotta make the money first. Then when you get the money, you get the power. Then when you get the power, then you get the woman. That's why you gotta make your own moves.
What's happening, YouTube? It's your boy Sot checking back in, man. Shout out, baby. All right, man. SWAT team in prison. So everybody already know you got everything in prison. You got drugs, phones, weapons, food, guards. You get everything. You know, same shit, just on a different level. You feel me? Just like you got the man out there on the streets. The big time dope dealer, the big time drug dealer, the trap house, all that shit. Same thing in prison. There's always one or two big men on the unit. These one or two guys have two or three guards in their pocket and they getting all the dope in. For example, this guy, he could be getting all the marijuana in. This guy, he could be getting all the tune in. The heroin, drugs, whatever, you feel me? But you got a bunch of people that mix and mingle once the drugs hit the unit. That person's making a killing. Whoever's bringing all the drugs in, the guard and the inmate, they got the guard and the inmate that's in cahoots bringing all the shit in, they making a killing. So, same way it work in the street. You got the wholesale. So if I'm the man, I got 10 pounds of some good, I'm finna issue it out to maybe about 20 people. I'm gonna bust half of those pounds. I'm gonna bust them down. You feel me? 10 pounds, bust them all in halves. I'm gonna issue it out to 20 people in the penitentiary. 20 people that I can trust. 20 people that I fuck with. 20 people that know that not to play with my money or my product. You feel me? So what happens when you the man and you making big moves and making moves like this in prison? And saying that what they say, all good things come to an end. That is very true. It's like in the world, you start making a name for yourself. Same thing in prison. You start making a name for yourself. Word getting shot out there that you making moves, doing your thing, making plays. People start coming straight to you. They skip the middleman. This is where a lot of guys make mistakes in prison. They don't use the buffer no more. Because prison, you have access to everybody, so it's not where in the world you have to drive to somebody's house and pull up on it. Somebody don't want you at their house in the world. They're not going to invite you or let you come to their house. You feel me? It's different in prison. I come ask, let's just say I'm looking for some drugs. I come ask your runner or your worker, whoever you gave the work to, I go ask them, like, well, damn, what's up, man? I'm trying to get 2 sticks, 3 sticks, something like that. And they be like, man, I'm dry. I'm all out, man. I ain't got shit. You got guys that are dope fiends or strung out on drugs in there that instead of taking that no, they'll go to the next guy. And he'll take a no. Then they'll go to the next guy. So basically, they fiending. They finna find it somehow, some way. And this is usually where the trouble starts. When you got somebody fiending, asking everybody for drugs, remember, in prison, everybody's not a part of this society, the drug society. I don't give a fuck what these prison channels tell y'all. Half these motherfuckers that do time in prison will never touch a drug or be mixing and mingling a drug because you got to be a certain status. You got to be with a certain group to be in the mix for the phones, drugs, stuff like that. Now, it's easy, yeah, to get access to a stick or two, you know what I mean? That being you just a crackhead on the street looking for some drugs, you feel me? But to actually get some weight, you got to remember, the guards are bringing it in, so it's very few people who are going to be locked in that circle. So this is how you get popped, though. So once you start making a name for yourself, you got this crackhead around here looking for drugs. He already asked all your runners, and they out of drugs. Now, guess who he looking for? He looking for you, the main motherfucker, because he already done whoop, did his research, so he pull up on you. Man, what's up, man? I ain't got nothing. Same shit all your people up under him just told you. That they asked out, they don't have nothing. But this motherfucker made it his business to come find out himself if you have anything, you feel me? But you give them the same answer. Nah, it's good, homie. We ain't got it. It's dry right now. It's dead right now. Once one motherfucker find out this is the man, he getting it in, that's where your problem. Once one motherfucker find out it's like a chain reaction, you feel me? Then two motherfuckers find out. Then three motherfuckers find out. In prison, once three or more know, it's over with. The whole unit. Consider the whole unit knows after three or more people. That's how it works, man. Typical day in prison, they do random shakedowns. You'll never know if it's a random shakedown. They don't ever come and say, hey, this is a random shakedown, or this is a snitch shakedown type shit. I call it snitch shakedown, meaning an informant or somebody that drop word that it's some plays being moved, it's some drugs in this cell, it's some phones in this cell, or it's something in this cell. We call that ratting, snitching, you know, dropping a kite, shit like that, you feel me? Once you get the moving like that, too many people know. Now you got the snitches knowing, you got the people that's trying to get out of prison knowing, that will do whatever it takes to get out of prison knowing. They don't give a fuck. Then you got the people that's jealous knowing. And then you got the competition that's knowing. They looking, they trying to take out whoever. They trying to take out whoever is stopping their product from moving. So they might pay somebody to get your shit crossed out or get your cell ran through. That's how it is in prison. It's a dirty game, you feel me? So usually when they, so in prison, if you get caught with marijuana in your cell, that's the only drug you can pretty much get caught with and not catch a charge. You still gonna catch a charge, but it's discretional, you know what I mean? They can either charge you for it or they can just lock you up and throw away the weed. Most, because marijuana is becoming so normal now in the world, they don't charge you for it no more in prison. But don't get it twisted, it's a felony charge. Getting caught with any kind of drug, any cigarette, any kind of tobacco, anything in prison is a felony charge for simple fact, illegal substances inside of an institution, you know what I mean? So, but they don't sweat the small shit. You get caught with a pound, your ass going under, shit like that, they gonna prosecute. You get caught with some sticks, they gonna throw that shit out, they ain't got time. But no matter what, mandatory, you get popped with a jag or a horn, hands down, you finna catch more time. They finna go file that charge on you, you know what I mean? So this is how they catch you. Most guys in prison, when word is that there's finna be a shakedown or some shit is in the air, you gotta get rid of your shit or it's last minute, most guys flush, they go straight to that toilet and flush and get rid of whatever they got. From a cell phone to any kind of drug. When you say how you flush a cell phone, most guys just put it in a sock, a little regular sock, long sock, and just go to banging it against the wall, the concrete ground, crushing it up in little pitted pieces and flush that bitch down the toilet. Now, there have been instances or circumstances where you don't have enough time to move like that. And I'm finna tell y'all, so this is how it works. When a SWAT team or they got some good knowledge, or let's just say you making major moves and you the big man. If they know you the big man and most of the drugs coming in, they already got word from other inmates, snitches, guards, all that shit. This is how they hit your spot. They first thing first, they're going to hit your shit at nighttime or early in the morning. 9 times out of 10, early in the morning while you sleep. Surprise attack. Same thing in the world. They motherfucking hit you early in the morning, SWAT team. If you back there in lockup, seg, or anything, y'all in the cell. So first thing first, they kill all water. Kill all water. Once all the water gone, they hit that bitch full speed. You can't flush shit. This is how it go. Ain't no jumping up, none of that shit. When she hit the fan, they come in that bitch. They turn off all the water, and that's your first sign. So if you happen to be at the toilet or at the sink brushing your teeth or using the water or flushing, and that bitch don't flush or the water ain't coming out, you got a heads up right then and there that they finna shake this bitch down. Most guys, when they catch on like that, they'll shoot word out there, hey, shake down, coming, shake down, the water off, the water off, the water off, y'all, the water off mean they coming, y'all. So hide your shit, get rid of it, shoot it out your cell. You can't flush shit, but just get it out your cell because you don't want to get popped with anything and catch more time, you feel me? They hit that bitch, they come in that bitch about 5-6 deep, pull you and your celly out, they turn the water off, and whatever's in that cell, it's you and your celly. That's it. Whatever's in that bitch. So if it's nothing of your, say if your celly is in the game and you not, you a good kid, you just trying to go home. 9 times out of 10, you and your celly already talked about this. And if anything ever happened, your celly done made it understood that he either gonna pay you to take the charge. Yeah, they pay. Or he gonna take his lick. You feel me? A lot of guys, will do whatever for money in prison. They'll take another, they'll take a lick, they'll take a gamble. We call it a lick. They'll take a gamble, meaning I'll take this, you get, that they run in our cell and this is my weed and my cellie had nothing to do with it. And I tell my cellie, look, man, I'm about to go home, man. I only got this, and this. I'm about to go home, man. You still got 20 years, this and that. Take this charge from me. A lot of guys will do it. You pay them, say, all right, well, get your people to send my people $100. Cash App. So this is how you send money in prison too, because a lot of people ask that. Cash App, Walmart to Walmart transfer, stuff like that. You just hop on the phone, say, hey, send, you just hop on the phone, tell your sister, brother, mama, whoever you get, say, hey, send $100 to this Cash App name, and boom, it's taken care of. Get legal in jail, there's an investigation done, and they can either contact the GI or not. I mean, they can either contact the IG or not. I think it's called the OIG, y'all. But the IG is the person that comes and files charges on you with the prison. With the county. So the OIG is the person that comes, investigate, find out, like, all the evidence they need, and they take it to the prosecutor and file charges against you to catch more time. Any time that you catch in prison is stacked. So the typical time for getting popped with a cell phone in Texas prison is 5 years. You feel me? A contraband phone, 9 times out of 10, they gonna come take you to trial. And if you go to trial, you gonna get the 5 years. If you don't go to trial, they'll offer you 2, 3 years, 4 years, whatever. You know what I mean? Every circumstance is different, depending on how bad they want you. You feel me? But it's a gamble that's not worth it. You feel me? Even if you got 20 years and you take this, even if you got 20, 30 years and you take this charge and get more time, you got to remember, one day you will come up for parole. One day you will be coming up to go home. And when that day pops up and you remember back in 10 years ago when you took that charge for somebody that was going home just to get it off and you wasn't thinking about the time, you just took the money at the time, you got to fade that later on, or you got to fight another case. So that's stupid. But a lot of guys take them chances down there, especially if they got 50, 40 years. I mean, I understand, too. They're like, hell, I'll take the time for you because, I mean, if you pay me, I'll take the time for you because I already got 50 years. That's how we work the system. That's how people buck the system down there, too, and get in the dope game, get in the trade, get in the game, you feel me? Because say, for instance, I had a 10-year sentence and I'm in the game. If I get popped with anything, drugs, phone, whatever, any time stacked is going to affect me, you feel me? Because I only got 10 years. So I'm going to do what it takes to get somebody else to take this charge or this pop, you feel me? That's just the way prison work, you feel me? You're going to try to get somebody to take that charge, pay them whatever you need to get done so you can go home. And it's a lot of guys with 50 life sentence that will take that charge. And usually with a life sentence, that's the only time they don't prosecute you for having a phone, any kind of drugs or anything, because hell, they don't give a fuck. They know that you're not going, they know that it's just a waste of time of the system. So they won't prosecute nobody with like a life sentence or 60 years. They won't add time to their shit because people like that don't give a fuck. They just keep getting time added. But when SWAT team hits that motherfucking, when SWAT team hits your cell, it is very real, just like the world, man. They gonna turn that water off. They gonna come in that bitch 5-6 deep. Y'all gonna be ass naked. They gonna make everybody get ass butterball ass naked. And you ain't coming out that bitch with nothing. Nothing. They want to make sure you ain't got shit. No drugs, no phones, nothing hidden in your ass, nothing hidden in your mouth, nothing behind your ears. You do the whole squat and cough thing. You know what the fuck I'm talking about. And I told this story to relate kind of to the world. No matter what the situation is, even if you're in the world trapping or if you're in the prison trapping, it's only a matter of time before somebody snitches on you, somebody drops word to the spot, gets hot, and the laws run up in your shit. You feel me? So you gotta have a plan. You gotta get away from that life. Period. It's only a matter of time. Shit only lasts so long, man. And with that being said, it's been real. It's your boy Sock signing off, man. Much love and respect. Y'all go drop a comment below. Hit that subscribe button. And most of all, push that motherfucking like button.